Hey, welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. I'm happy to see you today. We are talking about Google Docs for business, how to use them for business, how to share those documents. You're going to be networking like crazy with this stuff. So stay tuned. I'm going to show you how it's done. Hey, let's chat Google Docs and how to use them. If you watch one of our other videos, you know how to create it, you know how to put it together and use those templates to your advantage. Now we're gonna talk about how to use them for business specifically. So go ahead and go to google.com. You can pull up another window and do this right along with me. I'm gonna show you some of the functionality and the capabilities of Google Docs now that you've got yours all set up. So if you go over here and you click on your 9 square box, you're gonna scroll down, click more, and then you're gonna see Google Docs show up right there. That's going to take you to Google Docs. I always recommend, if you see here on my screen, I have Google Docs as a tab right here. So if you ever want to do that, if you ever find yourself using a website really a lot of the time or very, very frequently, you can actually click this right here and just drag it and put it in your bar. A little bit of an extra bonus for you. So if I just click that, or I just click Google Docs directly from my shortcuts, it's going to take me here. Now, Google Docs does interact with Google Drive in a very specific way. Google Drive will allow you to put multiple things into a single folder. So let's say you've got information in Google Docs, you've got information in Google Photos, you've got information in Google Sheets. All of that gets put together in what's called Google Drive. Google Drive is kind of the umbrella for everything. So if you have documents and you have photos that are both relevant to the same topic, let's say you're creating a recipe and you've got photos for the recipe and you've got the actual text for the recipe, you need them all in one place. They're going to be in a folder on Google Drive that you can put together and have in place. Now, Google Documents specifically can integrate with all of that, but they can also stand alone on their own. So here's what Google Docs will look like, especially if you've already got some. The default on Google Docs is to have them last opened by me, as far as ordering goes, which can make it a little bit tricky to find what you're looking for if you can't really remember, you know, when you last opened it. So you can sort them differently. You can sort them by last modified by me, last modified, the title. That'll be very handy. And you can also open up folders. So this is what I was talking about in Google Drive. You can have all of these things in different folders, and you can find your documents according to the folder that they're in. This is especially helpful if you're sharing this folder with other people. For example, I've got a group of women that I work with on a weekly basis, and we're always adding documents and files and sheets and pictures, and we're always putting them together. So we have this one folder right here that we put all of our information in so that we can easily find and manage it. So if I were to create a document and it's not going to be used until next week or maybe next month, then I can create it, put it in the folder, and even if they have this as last opened by me, I can go to the folder and find it quickly, especially if that document's created several weeks or a month ago. So this is what it looks like. I mean, we created a document for another video. We put that brochure on top. I've got several different documents down here. Again, this is all put together by last opened by me. This is how this is put together. Now I'm gonna open up a document that we use for another video called the brochure. And in this document, we're gonna show you how to get this really shared and edited by other people. Now let's say that this is a document that was shared with you by someone else, meaning that they created it and they wanted to get your input on it. Now I can go in here without changing the body of the document. I can make what are called suggestions. I love this feature. If you ever want to write a book or you're an editor, this is the way to go. Now this text in here, this is auto-filled by Google, so it's pretty much garbage text. So if I, for example, pretend that this is real text and I say, oh, I would really want this to say something different, I can highlight that and say, oh, I would delete that, and I would actually say, this is the verbiage that I would like to see here. And it would be shown as an edit. Now, anyone else looking at this document is gonna say, oh, Marianne, she made a suggestion to this document, and whoever makes the final say on this document can either click the check mark to accept the suggestion or to reject the suggestion. So I can click the check mark here. If I do that and I'm in charge of this document, it's going to change everything the way I suggested it. Now, if I make another sentence right here and say, this is the other sentence, now we've got a misspelling here. Okay, so I can go in as the editor of this document and say, okay, I like it, but I would really spell that correctly if I were you. Or I actually don't like it. I liked it the way I had it before with the really weird spelling of all this different language. If I reject that, then it's just going to go away and it won't appear in the final edit of the document. Now, the cool part is you can have multiple eyes and ears and fingers on this document at the same time. So for example, if I sent this out to my team and they said, team, I want you to make this document perfect. I want you to make any suggestions. I want you to add your input here and there. If I were to send this out to two or more people and they were making the suggestions, just as you see here in this top right corner, everyone's suggestions would show up differently. So if I were to make a suggestion here and just replace that text, and let's say that I want to leave a comment on someone else's suggestion, I would say, why do you think this should be here? And I can actually comment on someone else's suggestions before it's integrated into the document. Not enough people know that this exists. That I just want you to be aware of this. I actually use this in parenting. So I've got a daughter that's going into junior high this year, and she's got Google Documents is her thing. That's how she writes her reports. That's how her teachers want her to submit reports. And I totally get why. I wish I had that in high school. But she will replace, or she will send me all of her drafts of her homework and say, Mom, will you give this a look over? And I totally will make this suggestion and put these in there for her so that I'm not doing her homework, but I can take a few minutes while I'm working one day and just check that out. Great for work, great for home use, great for any use where you have any kinds of documents whatsoever. So once you've got all those suggestions put together, you've got everything that you need. You can also edit as a viewing, read, or print final document. So if you're about to send this out and you want to see how it's going to look before any of your clients see it, click the viewing. You won't be able to make any edits. You can highlight stuff, but you won't be able to change anything. That's how that rolls. Then you've got all these extra icons here. You can print it off. You can paint format. I never use this one, to be honest with you. You can do, you know, change the zoom on the document. You can change your text, change your fonts, change your font size. You can get all of these different things in here, put links in there, put comments in there. So let's say if you want to make a suggestion without necessarily changing any of the text, wherever your cursor is, you can leave a comment. So let's say that your employees sent you this memo and you want to send it back with a comment. You can just put your cursor there, leave the comment, send it back. It won't change anything, but they'll be able to see it. In the final print, they won't, but in the editing version, they will. You can add images in there, make it justified, do your line spacing different, all of these functions, just like you would see in any other Word editing format, Microsoft Word. Documents is a go-to for business. If you need to communicate with one another, if you need to get something out the door, guys, imagine how many hours of meetings this will save you. Never organize a meeting that could be accomplished in a well-worded email. This is your ticket to doing that. If you don't have Google Docs, get Google Docs. Put it on your phone, put it on your mobile devices, download it everywhere you can so your seamless integration can be just that, absolutely seamless. So what do you think of that video? Was that helpful for you? Is that gonna help you, you know, grow some business, create some connections? Let me know in the comments. Hit the subscribe button so I can chat with you tomorrow. I'll see you then.